Hello everyone, this is Amish. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about the movie Driving License, starring Prithvi Raj and Suraj, and directed by Lal Jr., who I believe is the son of Lal. I think I've seen him perform in a couple of movies. But that is that. And now getting to the review of the movie, I really don't know where to begin. First of all, didn't have any expectations based on the trailer or the promotion of the movie. It seemed really dull and silly to begin with. And then after the movie released, there was a pretty mixed opinion. There were people who actually liked this movie, people who felt it was not that bad. And therefore, I watched this movie because the public reaction was not that this movie is a disaster. The public enjoyed this movie is what I hear. I don't know. So correct me if I'm wrong. But me also being part of the public, I watched this movie and I do not think and I do not understand why this movie was made, how it was made, how it came to be. And it makes me think of so many different things that put me in an existential crisis altogether. Now, to begin with, Prithvi Raj and Suraj are both known for, especially of late, you know, they're both known for content films, you know, great concepts, great content, arty films, films that are new age, new concept. And everyone has been appreciating them for their strong performances and choice of scripts. They may not work every time at the box office, but they have always been appreciated, at least by the film lovers, critics, and the others. Now, this combination coming together in 2020, you would have thought that they would pick a script that is high content and high concept and is worthwhile of both their time. However, Driving License is obviously not that script. It is one of the most silliest scripts I have seen ever. And obviously it has so many open loopholes and things and so many faults all over the place that you wonder why they did this film. Bring me to my next point, that the reason they probably did this film is because it was Lal Jr.'s film. I guess it is Lal Jr.'s first film, or, you know, he's beginning out now. But that is probably one of the reasons that there's goodwill in the Malayalam film industry, good relations. And that is why you see every superstar, every actor do at least one absolutely terrible film every year. And I do not know why they do it, but that's the only explanation, that they just want to do it because of relationships, friendships, or even just trying to build up someone's career and not caring about the fact that one or two flop films will change their career, because that's not how it works in the Malayalam film industry. Mohanlal has been giving flops after flops, and even recently his movie Big Brother, I think, with Arbaaz Khan, was an absolute disaster. But nevertheless, people are, you know, obviously he's still a number one and he's still going to break the records with Marakkar. So this is something that's a trend in the industry, and unfortunately Driving License is one of those films. Now, some of you will say, well, it was not that bad, it was not entertaining enough, etc, etc. But that's not how I would approach the film, because of course it is not the worst thing I've seen. I could watch it for the most part and there was nothing terrible about it. The starting portion was good, the ending portion was good, but in the middle it really became something very silly. And, you know, I just don't know, why would you make a film on this story? I don't get it. And take these two big actors who have hopes and expectations from to drive the industry forward and put them on such a movie. For example, in that scene where there are so many scenes. The example in one of the scenes, you know, where Prithvi Raj announces something to the crowd and he leaves in his car, and then he comes back because Suraj is getting beaten up to sort of take him in the car. And even while he's taking him and he's announcing to everyone and he's sort of hitting a couple of people to stay away from Suraj, why is the crowd still hitting Suraj and sort of still, you know, not listening to the person they worship and they're doing it for? Even when the car drives away, where Prithvi Raj has clearly put him in his own car and taken him away to safety, why is the crowd still running behind this car? You know, why? What are they trying to prove at this point? So a lot of those kind of little things just made it seem very questionable, and there were many such other moments as well. as to you thought like this was just not required in the film at all. Now, the only good part, the couple good parts that I liked in the movie is the starting scene when Prithviraj enters the police station and, you know, completely disconnects from what is going on and loses his mind and has a temper. That scene was absolutely good because of the reaction of Suraj and his son. I think that was a nice turning point, and you would think that this is a very mature film where it is about how a dad is his son's hero and does not care about his own dreams, his hopes, his ambitions, his desires being fulfilled when his son is being hurt or his son is in tears. Everything goes to shit. What matters is the kid. And that moment was very well captured. And for me, you know, up until that moment, I was really feeling it. And I got excited when the movie went in that direction, in that scene. I was like, this movie is good. This is going to be good. It's not going to be a silly thing between two adults. It's there's emotion behind why Suraj would react in this way, you know. It's not like the movie Fan or something like that where, you know, it's just a crazy fan going crazy for no reason and trying to show some ego matters. It's not just that. I thought there was the good emotional backing for what is going to happen next in the film. And although that theme is generally maintained consistently, which is the best part of the film, because it keeps giving Suraj the motivation to go against Prithviraj because his son is being hurt in various ways, unfortunately it doesn't really play out that well. Suraj does all this research and, you know, says that you can't take the edge test today, but then he's like, never mind, take it, you're fine. He then says that there's some bullshit reason why you're not good at the edge test, and then he's like, he gets an order from his senior saying that no, it's fine, rub it off. So you know, all this just generally feels like, you know, what is going on right now? Like, what is this? This is just getting sillier and sillier. And even the whole scene, which is probably the worst part of the movie, the whole questionnaire, which even the public says like this is like KBC or whatever, that whole part was just so unnecessary. You know, all the media, all the mics for this one learner's test, it is like completely, I don't get it. I probably missed why it was there, but I don't get it. So generally, I feel like it's very unrealistic. It was unnecessary. The other characters which were included in there for comedy were not funny enough, whether it's the other actor, the other superstar who was there, who was a superstar in the movie. His plot was very flat, and the other actor, I think Salim, forgot his name, who plays the drunkard who's trying to get to Prithviraj for some reason, was also completely weird. I don't even know why would they take him. He's such a good actor and has acted in several movies, and they just give him this random role. So it was all over the place. And I think that even though they might be supporting Lal Jr. or the, you know, supporting other youngsters to come up, they should give their inputs into how they can make things better, and how to, you know, take a movie to a little bit of a next level than just let it be as it is. It doesn't make a lot of sense. So, not a very successful film for me, not a very well done film at all. I'm going with 2 stars for Driving License. I hope you like this review. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and keep watching for more.